In part 2 of our lesson on the graphs of secant and cosecant, we will create the graph of cosecant. From our reciprocal identities, we know that cosecant of x is equal to 1 over the sine of x, which means it's a rational function, and that means it has vertical asymptotes when its denominator, which is sine of x, is equal to 0, and its numerator, which is 1, does not equal 0. Well, of course, 1 can never equal 0. So that means any place that sine of x has a root, cosecant of x will have a vertical asymptote. So we can see there are roots for the sine of x at negative 2 pi, negative pi, 0, pi, and 2 pi. So those will translate into vertical asymptotes on the graph of cosecant of x. So negative 2 pi, negative pi, 0, pi, and 2 pi. Now, to make the graph, we can plot a couple points here and then do some analyzing. So if we pick some x values and then determine the cosecant of x, let's pick x is pi over 2. We know from our unit circle graph that the sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1, then the cosecant will be 1 over 1, which is 1. So we plot the point pi over 2, 1. And as we did with the graph of secant, let's analyze what's happening on the sine curve. The y values for sine of x are going towards 0 as the x values approach pi. So if sine of x is going to 0 and it is in the denominator of cosecant, then that means that 1 over sine of x has to be heading off to infinity. Same going on this piece of the sine graph. Sine of x is going to 0, so if the denominator is going to 0, the fraction, meaning cosecant, has to go to infinity. If we pick an x value of 3 pi over 2, we know that the sine of 3 pi over 2 is negative 1. 1 divided by negative 1 is negative 1, so cosecant of 3 pi over 2 is negative 1. We plot that point. Sine is going to 0, so if the denominator is getting smaller and smaller and smaller, the fraction is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Now, because sine is going through negative numbers on its way to 0, that means as cosecant gets huge, it will be getting huge in the negative direction. Same over here, as sine approaches 0, the cosecant is going to approach negative infinity because sine is going through negative numbers. At negative pi over 2, we know the sine of negative pi over 2 is negative 1, so 1 over negative 1 means the cosecant is negative 1. Plot that point. And as the sine is approaching 0 through negative numbers, that means the cosecant is approaching negative infinity. And at negative 3 pi over 2, we know that the sine of negative 3 pi over 2 is 1, so 1 over 1 means the cosecant of negative 3 pi over 2 is 1. Sine is going to 0 through positive numbers, so cosecant will be approaching positive infinity. And now we're ready to analyze this graph. To get the period of the graph, we have to subtract the end of a cycle minus the start of a cycle, and we have to include all the possible y values. So it's very customary to start at 0 and end the cycle at 2 pi. So the period, 2 pi minus 0, of course, is 2 pi. The domain has infinitely many x values we have to exclude. On this piece that we have graphed, we can see we have to exclude negative 2 pi, negative pi, 0, pi, and 2 pi. We notice that all of these x values that we have to exclude are just integer multiples of pi away from each other. So for instance, if we start here at 0, to get to the next one, it's just adding pi. To get over here, we'd have to add 2 pi. To get back this way, we would have to subtract pi. To get to here, we would have to subtract 2 pi. So the domain is that x cannot equal n pi. For the range, we see this is going to be exactly like it was for secant, where the values go from negative infinity up to negative 1. And then from negative 1, they jump up to positive 1 and then go on forever. So positive 1 to infinity. The formula for the vertical asymptotes we get for free from the domain, because every x value that we have to exclude from the domain, the reason we're excluding it is because it is a vertical asymptote. So the formula for vertical asymptotes is that x will equal n pi. Our normal cycle that we're going to use for graphing is the one that starts at 0 and goes to 2 pi. So let's take a look at the values of n we're going to have to pick to get our vertical asymptotes in the normal cycle. We see that the first vertical asymptote is at 0, so we're going to want to pick 0 for n to get x equals 0 for our asymptote. The second vertical asymptote is at pi, so we're going to want to pick n equals 1 to get x equals pi as our vertical asymptote. The third asymptote is at 2 pi, so we're going to pick n is equal to 2 so that we get x equals 2 pi for our vertical asymptote. So this is our normal cycle. From 0 to 2 pi. We can make a summary chart of all the attributes of the secant and cosecant graphs. We know that the period for secant is 2 pi. Its domain was that the x values are not allowed to be pi over 2 plus n pi. The range is negative infinity up to negative 1, union 1 to positive infinity. The formula for the vertical asymptotes, they occur at x equals pi over 2 plus n pi. Remember, every value that we have to exclude from the domain is because it is a vertical asymptote of the function. And the normal cycle goes from negative pi over 2 to 3 pi over 2. So this is very different than sine and cosine and tangent and cotangent. Now the cosecant, the period was also 2 pi. Its domain was that we have to exclude the x values that are multiples of pi, so x cannot equal n pi. The range is exactly the same as secant, negative infinity to negative 1, union 1 to positive infinity. The formula for the vertical asymptotes is that x has to equal n pi. The vertical asymptotes happen at the exact places we have to exclude from the domain. And the normal cycle for cosecant is from 0 to 2 pi. So this is just a quick summary for your convenience of looking up attributes of these secant and cosecant graphs.